Hey everybody, it's Dr. A again, and this time in this video I want to take a look at the tech quest. So it's kind of a big document. It can seem a little unwieldy and maybe difficult to get a firm grasp on at first, but I think once we dig in we'll see that it's really a great way for you to take control over what you want to learn and to maybe solidify some concepts for you and also stretch yourself a bit. So here in Blackboard, maybe you're at the home page and you can click on information and syllabus. Notice now I have an introduction video that I just completed for you, and then this one will go here in the Tech Quest area. So if we click Tech Quest, it gives you a description of the tech quest that we'll kind of go over right now. And it mentions that you have a link to a view-only document. So I'll click that document, and it takes you here to a document that you are only able to view. You're not able to edit this document. This is just for reference. So let's take a look at the structure. So the idea behind this approach to the class is a little bit from gamification concepts and really just creating ownership over your learning. And instead of starting from a deficit model where you have an A and you just lose it, you're starting from basically clean slate and you are earning points toward that 400 point goal. So this is organized in a couple of different ways. First, notice that as I scroll down, there's a point where it says Tech Quest check number one. So everything before this are all activities that are in some way aligned with the first 4 weeks of instruction. You are not required to complete all of your 100 points from the first week. You can jump around if you like, okay? So for example, if I look at this, there are some that are mandatory that you have to do, and we'll get back to that in a second. I'll give you an example of how you might load this up on a Google site. But for example, let's say that you're really into tech and you jump down a ways and you notice that there is something about scripting here, creating a Google script, and maybe you really think, oh, that's amazing, I want to do that. So you can complete this activity ahead of week seven if you wish. But I want you to note that it's from TPE5. That's going to become important here in a second. So from weeks one through four, you'll notice that one of them is required. And this is the 20 points that you'd get. It's kind of double dipping, but that's okay. Well, I should change this. It says not, I don't want 2 to 4. This is a 3 to 4 page. This is a paper about the SAMR theoretical structure, which we'll get into a little bit more detail later on. But as you look at these, you notice that they're all worth point values. And what I would say in general, if you think, well, okay, this demonstrating proficiency with keyboard shortcuts is worth 10 points. How much time should I spend on that? You may spend 5 minutes because you know how to do that, or you may have to research a little bit and spend more time. I would say that these activities should take you about an hour for every 10 points that they're worth. So this is at most a 1 hour activity. Down here, this is a 30 point activity, so it's going to take you a little bit longer because it's asking you to complete some courses on the GCF Learn Free website. So again, as you're looking at this, notice the different colors correspond to a different TPE. So as you're working through the entire tech quest, make sure that you have different TPEs covered in your activities that you complete. So you're looking to complete activities in each of the TPEs that we cover in this course. Okay. So this is just the view only. You kind of hopefully get the idea that this is a spreadsheet that's structured to give you a choice of activities. And you can see how they're grouped is by weeks 1 through 4 to give you an idea of how they might align to your studies, but you are not required to, in week 1, do anything from week 1 unless it's mandatory. You're also not required to do everything from week 1. This is your choice. Your goal is to simply complete 400 points. Notice that you're only going to get credit for an activity. It mentions here, if you have a brief 3 or 4 sentence description on how you might be able to use this in technology in the classroom. Also here we have a color-coded legend with the number of tech quest activities that you have to choose from each TPE 1, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so back to Blackboard. Here is what I want you to do after you take a look at the document and familiarize yourself with it. Open your Gmail account and sign in. Then you're going to click this link, and what it should do is say, would you like to make a copy of this in your drive? And you will say, yes, make a copy. When you do that, it is going to give you the choice of where to save it. And then here, what you'll do is you will change your last name and first name. And I'll just put these little separators. And then that's your new document. Okay. I'm going to revert back because I think this is the document that everyone sees. Okay, once you've done that, you're going to go up here to share, and you're going to share this document by clicking share, and then in people, you'll enter my email address. Make sure I have at least commenting rights, and then click send. Okay. So once you've done that, then you can start working on your portfolio and marking some of these as completed. So for example, here, read the syllabus online and leave a comment. And let's see how we might do that. I've already created a portfolio. This is through Google Sites. It's really easy to create a website. You can do some Googling to find out how you might do that. But you'll click on sites, or you'll type in sites.google.com, and it's going to take you to, if you don't own, so I'll just click own by me. If you don't own a website, then you click the red button here to create one. This is my website, and this is what it looks like when I'm in edit mode. Okay, this is what it looks like when it's an actual website and you've published it. So what we're going to do is let's complete this one together. Read the syllabus online and leave a comment. So I'm going to go to the syllabus. I'm going to click on just the title here. Notice when I highlight something, it gives me this option for add a comment. I'll do that. I'll say, hi everyone, welcome to 4200, comment. So you're going to take that proof that you did that, put it on your website. You should find out how to take a screenshot using keyboard shortcuts and not by taking a picture with your cell phone. So I already know how to do that on a Mac. I'm just going to take that screenshot. And that's going to help me in a minute here as I go back to edit my website. Notice that I have a home page. I also have a page for TPE 1, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I need to find out on the tech quest, this one that's mandatory, read the syllabus online. That's from TPE 4. So I'll go to the TPE 4, page. not the sorry page, but the TPE4 page, and my apologies. And I'm going to go over here to layouts and see which one I might want to drag over. Knowing that I have a screenshot and I want to put in some text, I'll use this one. I'm going to drag it over. And the title is Comment on Syllabus. Cool. And I'm going to add in, upload an image from my desktop screenshot, open. Okay. And I might just type a 3-4 sentence. I think that having students communicate blah, blah, blah. And you get the picture. I'm not going to type out the entire 3-4 sentences, but now this is done. Okay, so I'll click publish. It's publishing the website, and it's publishing this bit of information here, or this proof. I go back to my web page, click TPE4, and you can see it's now shown up. So what happens is you take that home page. What I can do here is I can go to pages, go to my home page, and where do I get? So copy publish site link. So right up here, and I'll copy that link, and that goes into the housekeeping file under website link. So I'll put in my website link. And this is my file, so I can see your website links. And then anytime that there is a TechQuest checkpoint, I just click on that link and it's all there for me to see. And you don't have to continue to share it with me over and over again. So just a quick review is, let's start here at Blackboard. You can reference the view-only document. Get yourself familiarized with it. Notice that there are some mandatory items here, including this required signature assignment. Notice it's laid out by weeks, but you're not required to complete assignments by week. You can skip around, but I am asking you to complete different activities in all of the TPE modules. I don't think I stated the reason for that. I will when I get back to the website. When you're done with this, mark it as yes, and notice that it says you've completed one quest worth 10 points, so it's keeping that running total for you. Okay. So that was the view only. You won't have that access on the view only. If you recall, you'll have to go down here and make your own copy. As you complete these, make sure that you share with me, okay, using the people and using my dr2pi@gmail.com. Make sure that you also start a Google site, that you keep track of your activities in the TPE pages that you're making, and then share that with me in the housekeeping document that you can find here on the syllabus all the way down in week one. Make sure that you are bookmarking these sites if you ever get confused as to where they are, like references on the syllabus or in Blackboard. So hopefully that helps you with the TechQuest and to understand it a little bit more, and how we're going to keep track of our proof. So again, this is for you to direct your own learning. Pick the activities that you feel like you want to complete. You can definitely, if you're pretty skilled in tech, I'm sure that you can just game this system and do all the easiest stuff, but I'm leaving that up to you to try to be the best educator and student that you can be one day for your own students. So I think that's it for this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out via email. and we'll see you soon.